So then because of that, I crashed production. Oh. First commit, crashed production. Yay. But I mean, I still have my Jocelyn. So.
Hey everyone, what's happening? It's Mayuko. Today I'm joined here by JoMa.
What up? I'm JoMa. How you guys doing?
So today I want to answer a lot of questions that you've had about internships. Everything from how to get one and what to expect during one and everything in between. Between us, we've had a lot of internships.
Yep.
With all of our collective and combined experiences. Hopefully what we're going to talk about today is helpful for you. Also, JoMa, do you want to introduce yourself and talk about what you do? And...
Yeah, I guess, you know, I'm also a content creator. I go by the name of JoMa. My actual name is Jonathan Ma, and I've been working in tech for a while now. So yeah, hopefully we can shed some light on that.
So first we want to answer the question, why even do an internship?
Well, first of all, they're really important in terms of like personal development, skills development and all that. But for me, especially, I think it was really important in terms of, you know, meeting new people, meeting new friends. And I actually met some of my best friends through internships.
Oh, yeah, that's awesome. Mm-hmm. It is really fun hanging out with like people who kind of have similar career goals as you.
For sure.
And to be able to like make something together is really fun. Mm-hmm. Why I think internships are really important is because there's a lot of skills that you learn for software engineering in school, studying computer science, but there's a lot of hands-on skills that you also have to develop in order to become a good software engineer. So things like how to work in a team, how does the software development process and cycle work, what's Scrum and Agile, and all those things are really important and will help you kind of hit the ground running right after you graduate from college. Mm-hmm. And so learning those things during an internship is really great and you get a head start on them.
Yeah, that's for sure very true. Like I didn't even know what Git was until I started my internships. Like, because especially for my program, it's like computer science program. It's not a lot of software engineering, but more like theoretical computer science. Mm-hmm. Right, so I never actually learned how to like build stuff. Mm-hmm. I only learned like algorithms that we never use at all.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
So with these internships, I kind of knew like how to build stuff, like, you know, just simple things like Node.js apps and stuff like that. And yeah, it helps me like have a lot more fun coding.
Yeah, it does feel good to like know and understand what you learn in school actually translates to like stuff that you build that helps people. At least that's what I'm like really, really passionate about. And seeing that kind of like come to fruition and seeing real people use the software that you make is so rewarding.
Yeah.
So let's jump into a little bit about our background so we've kind of set some context. Mm-hmm. And so we can talk about like where we went to school and kind of what was the atmosphere and attitude toward internships at our respective schools.
Yeah, so for me, I went to University of Waterloo. Our school's a little bit different because we have to do 5 to 6 internships within your whole education career.
Whoa.
Yeah, so that's a lot.
Yeah.
So for us, you know, internships are, well, we call them co-ops, and they're a big part of our career. So we love internships. Our school is known for internships because we just do so many. But yeah, so that's kind of like how it is at our school.
So I went to UC San Diego as referenced in my other video. If you haven't checked that out, I'll leave a link in the description box below. The computer science program was really big and it was kind of the typical 4-year CS program basically. And while we didn't have requirements on having to do internships in order to graduate like your school did, a lot of people did internships at least once throughout their 4 years. Most commonly right after their 3rd year, which is the year right before they tend to graduate. We had job fairs on campus that helped students get these internships, as well as get full-time jobs after they graduate. So there's a lot of big companies like Google, Facebook, Apple, as well as more mid-sized companies too that were looking to hire students. So JoMa, can you tell me about what internships you have done and what companies they were at?
Yeah, sure. So I started my first internship at Citadel, which is kind of like a hedge fund company, as a software engineer. And then I did LinkedIn as a software engineer. And then I did Facebook as a data scientist, and then Microsoft as a program manager.
Whoa.
Yeah, a lot of different things.
Yeah.
A lot of soul searching.
That's good. That's what internships are
exactly,
good for too.
Exactly, that is, yeah.
So now we're gonna dive into how to get an internship. So JoMa, what's your best piece of advice on how to get an internship?
Yeah, so I guess for me, how I think about it, there's two phases. The first phase is getting the interview. And then the second phase is kicking ass in the interview. The first phase for me is you just gotta get recognized by the recruiter. So either by, you know, having a really good resume or getting a referral, I guess. And then the second part is more about acing the interview. And I suggest to just brush up on your coding interview skills And there's a good book on it, Cracking the Coding Interview. I'm sure you guys talked about it.
I think one thing that was really helpful for me was making friends with people who are older than me and kind of expanding my network. As they start working full-time jobs at their companies, they're going to usually be part of the recruiting efforts at their school to hire students. So JoMa, what are some things that you did to help you get these internships?
My story is a little bit different. I actually wanted to be an investment banker.
Oh, really?
I didn't want to be a software engineer. And then I did like trading competitions. I started also learning Python. I was really interested in finance, and there was a website called intrade.com where you could, you know, trade about events. Like, for example, is Obama going to win the election or not? And then what I did was I made a bot that kind of like values those like events. In an engineering point of view, it was, you know, pretty cool because I made a Python bot and it worked decently, you know? And yeah, I think that's how I got the attention of Citadel, my first internship.
I guess for me, as I explained in my other video, my first internship I got by first working there is kind of like an administrative assistant and doing that kind of like foot in the door thing where I would be not working as a software engineering intern, but I was working as someone else as like a different role. Soon after working that role, people knew who I was and like my work ethic and all that kind of stuff. So when I went to apply for the internship, they already knew who I was. And so they were like, cool, yeah, like you have a spot in the internship program.
Yeah, I guess that's another proof of like how networking is pretty important.
Yeah, and I know some people do hackathons. Some companies sponsor these hackathons and sometimes give out interviews or offers to kind of like the winning team. So that's one way. I remember professors at my university had connections with companies and recruiters. And so he would be able to like pick his like top students, maybe not necessarily by grade, but but the ones that he had a connection with and the ones that he really liked. And so, yeah, there's a lot of other ways to kind of like get noticed other than just like making a good resume and stuff. Yeah. One thing to note is that most companies tend to look for interns who are in their third year because they want to be able to hire that person full time after they graduate. And so it's kind of more rare to find internships for first and second year students, but it's also very possible to do so. It's just you have to find other ways of getting noticed, I think.
Yeah, definitely don't feel like, oh, I'm not qualified because of that, or because, oh, they rejected me, I'm probably not qualified. Sometimes you are qualified, but it's just too early because they actually want to turn you into a full-time right away. My friend, he had a team where they were competing on a Facebook hackathon because Facebook used to host hackathons around schools. And he had this app that allows you to turn your phone into a mouse pad so you could control your computer using your phone, and they won first place. And then because of that, all of them got an interview for Facebook.
Wow.
And then he aced the interview, and then he worked for Facebook as a freshman. So just because you're a freshman doesn't mean that you can't aim for like the top companies.
So now let's dive into kind of what you need to know before starting an internship. And here we want to highlight what are things that you should expect. So just some more information about the internship itself.
Yeah, sure. So I remember when I just got my first internship, you're super excited, you know, you're awesome. But then while, you know, you're almost to the actual day of the internship, you're like, oh my god, can I do this? Like, I'm a little bit scared. But I just want to tell you, don't be afraid. You know, it's normal that you're afraid, but you don't need to be, because a lot of the things that you don't know, you will learn. You know, they don't expect you to be, you know, as productive as a full-time employee. You're an intern, you're here to learn, and they're here to help you learn.
Yeah, I felt that every single time before any of my internships. I was like, am I qualified for this? Like, are you sure you want me? The imposter syndrome settled in so hard in my head. I was like, why do they want me? Like, oh, it's like weird. But yeah, once you start, it's like they have the program set up for you typically so that you can succeed in such a way that you're learning throughout the whole thing. You are there to learn, and so ask lots and lots of questions. Even things that you think are stupid questions, like ask them. The whole point, I think, of an internship is to really just absorb a lot of information and like every bit of it too. So there's an acronym you don't know, ask what it is, even if everyone else is throwing it around, like, you know what it is.
Like Git. Yeah. I didn't know what that was.
Yeah, that's okay. You're there to learn, so. One question that I get frequently is, do you need to know anything before an internship? Things like programming language and like tech stacks. JoMa, what do you think?
I personally don't think so. Maybe because I've been working for bigger companies, but big companies don't expect you to be an expert on any language. I didn't even know how to like write C++ code. And then they just expect you that you'll learn it on the job. So for me, I didn't need to. Like, for example, what happened at Citadel was I joined the team. They're like, oh, do you know C++? I'm like, no. And then they just, oh, it's okay, don't worry. And they just gave me a whole C++ book, and then I started coding, so.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they don't expect you to, like, be a pro at JavaScript, or even just, like, have... They don't expect you to have even written JavaScript before.
Right.
They have a whole code base that shows you how to write JavaScript, and there's software engineers who've been writing JavaScript for a long time that are going to show you how to learn those things. And so that's not like a requirement at all. I think what's more important is that you show that you're willing to learn and that you know that you don't understand everything. Like that's totally okay. So let's talk about after the internship. So JoMa, after all of your internship experiences, do you think that they helped you to decide what you wanted to do and what you didn't want to do?
Yeah, definitely. Like, especially because I tried like almost everything, like software engineering, data science, and PM, it really helped me understand like what I really wanted to do. And when I did software, like I realized like, oh, I really like building things. But for example, when I did data science, I understood like, oh, I really like analyzing data and the products. And then PM is more like, oh, I like, you know, thinking about the product and then execution. So that helped me understand that, oh, I think I did like data science more and I like PM a little bit more than software engineering. So that helped me kind of like choose my career.
Do you think that if you hadn't done those internships, but maybe you like studied those concepts in school, would you have had kind of the same sort of learnings?
Oh, yeah, definitely not. Because, you know, the stats classes in school is really basic and not applied at all. So I would never want to be a data scientist if, you know, if I just learned it from school.
Interesting.
Yeah, Facebook really helped me understand, like, you know, the impact that you can have using data.
Awesome. So we talked a lot about internships today, and I want to thank you for being on my channel.
Thank you for having me.
Where can everyone find you?
Yeah, sure. So you could definitely check me out at JoMa. I'm a very new creator. I only have like one video now, which is kind of like a mockumentary of me starting a startup. And yeah, like I'll be talking a lot about tech, and hopefully I can merge tech and entertainment into what it is, my channel.
Go check out his stuff. And you can always find me on Twitter and Instagram as HelloMayuko. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you like this video, and we will see you next time. Bye.
See ya.